I'd like to speak with you for a few minutes today about the tragedy that took place at Fort Hood. This past Thursday, on a clear Texas afternoon, an Army psychiatrist walked into the Soldier Readiness Processing Center and began shooting his fellow soldiers.
And as a husband.
It's an act of violence that would have been heartbreaking had it occurred any place in America. It's a crime that would have horrified us and its victims and Americans of any background. It's all the more heartbreaking and all the more despicable because of the place where it occurred and the patriots where it
made.
The SRP is where our men and women in uniform go when they
get briefed.
It's where they get their situation, their medical records.
We still don't know all the facts.
They make sure everything is in order.
Do know that several people have been shot.
In this place, the base where our soldiers launched field more safe news, where those brave Americans were preparing to risk their lives and the defense of our nation, lost their lives and our nation's
capital.
Soldiers stationed in Iraq, Afghanistan, and around the world called and emailed loved ones at
the airport,
all expressing the same concerns
and
overwhelming
patriots. They know the dangers.
Thursday shooting was the most devastating ever.
Today they face the unimaginable violence.
And even as we saw the worst of humanity, we also saw the best of America.
So we offer our
saw soldiers, Navy, and civilians alike rushing
law enforcement, federal authorities,
tearing off
the doctors who responded with skill and bravery,
using blouses.
I've made a career in my time to
hold down the shooters.
These seamless
birthdays, graduation,
we saw soldiers bringing to bear their own swords, skills they have been trained in skills that have been honed through years of determined efforts for one purpose.
Among the fallen were also teachers, men and women who devoted their lives to helping our children.
We saw the valor, selflessness,
and hardly
of broken that makes our servicemen and women the finest fighting force.
Grandparents
that make the United States military the best in the world ever known.
More about the greatest
make homeless adults who were lost. On Friday, I met with FBI Director Mueller,
hearts of broken
parents, representatives of all the agencies. They discuss their ongoing investigation into the homeland in this terrible emergency. I'll continue to be in close contact with them.
We
can't fully know what leads a man to do such a thing. But what we do know is that our
country, we have been through this too many times. Whether it's an elementary school,
thoughts are with all the families who have lost a loved
shopping mall in Oregon,
thoughts are with cousins,
Americans, movie theaters in the world.
I've been briefed by my team on the situation.
Neighborhoods
we still don't know all the facts.
These children
are. You know that several people in the military have been shot.
Tribute to those who fell at Fort Hood.
We are running
flags flying over the White House.
Other mass shooting of federal buildings.
The lower half of the state.
Every tier of the
now still Veterans Day.
Receiving Michelle and I will do what I know every
Veterans Day is our chance to honor those Americans who serve in the
personnel.
Lexington to Antioch,
men and women,
Normandy to
the brightest leaders,
and
will remind each other how deeply
and truly
we love one another.
This church is
a patriot American. They know the dangers of serving abroad.
They need all of us.
But today they face the unimaginable violence.
Hard days to come.
Their descendants of immigrants will be at our best.
Americans
we offer our gratitude to the Navy,
what they share,
law enforcement,
federal authorities,
space,
and the doctors
share as
files of skill and bravery.
I've made a career
in my team
that I want to
investigate.
They share the same
unflinching